eventual threat and impact of Sandy as it makes its way up the coast. But right now, also off to our left, we are watching a cold front that will be also working in our direction, adding a little bit to the mix as we head Sunday into Monday. But it looks like that frontal system not doing much to steer Sandy out to sea. In fact, things are looking more likely for an East Coast landfall anywhere from, say, the Delmarva Peninsula up to Maine, just dependent upon the model that you want to look at. So there's still some uncertainty with regards to the track and also to the timing. It looks like Monday into Tuesday of next week still seems to be the greatest threat time frame for us here across southern New England. So there again is the center of the storm emerging off of Cuba, moving now through the central Bahamas. The same winds are at 105 miles an hour. It is moving to the north of the Category 2. Weekends is forecast to do so to a Category 1 as we head into the upcoming weekend. It parallels the coast of the Carolinas, goes to the east. The center of the storm does, of course, to the east of the Outer Banks of North Carolina. But the storm is going to be a large one, so it's still going to be interacting with land, bringing heavy rain and wind. And then the track eventually from the National Hurricane Center brings it by Tuesday morning of next week, very close to New Jersey. And that puts Connecticut on the northeast quadrant, the actual worst part of the storm to be dealing with. And for us on this track, if it maintains, for Connecticut, it would mean heavy rain that would lead to possible flooding, talking about inches of rain. Also damaging winds, you could see them between 50 and 70 miles an hour. That, of course, could lead to widespread power outages. And then with a full moon coming on Monday, with astronomically high tides and that wind, the northeasterly wind piling the water in the Long Island Sound, could be talking about some substantial coastal flooding. So there's a lot to watch as we head through the coming days. Tomorrow, though, near 70, dry weather, a lot of sunshine, clouding back up on Saturday.